In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We come to commend the soul of our sister Hedy Post to a loving God. She is here surrounded by the flowers and the colors that she loved, and also by the image of Our Lady of Guadalupe, to whom she had a tremendous service. She loved Our Lady, who was part of her life. And in baptism, Hedy died with Christ and rose with him to a new life as a child of God. May she now rise with him to eternal life. And so we place on her coffin the crucifix, which shows us the Christ who has given his life for us and died for us. So we place the pall on the coffin.
James, can we slide up this? So, come on over. This is something we like the family to do. I'm going to place it on top, and the two of you are just going to stand on either side of it. Just kind of, you're going to help me, okay?
Yeah.
Just kind of unrolls, okay?
There you go.
Take a piece, yeah. Just slide it. Oops, so, one's out. There you go. All right, you're going to place this right here on mom, just like that. You're going to follow us all, and Priscilla's going to reach you.
Lord, you are with us in our coming and in our going. Be with us now as we make this last journey with our beloved sister, Hedy.
Our entrance hymn, I Am the Bread of Life.
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever, and I will raise you. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day.
And welcome to our celebration here this morning. The greatest gift that we can give our sister Hedy is the fact that we offer for her the Mass which Jesus gave us to pray for her and send our prayers rising to God for her immortal soul. We thank you for your presence here and for the consolation that you give Hedy, Reyna, her daughter, and all of us who knew her appreciate what the gift she was for us. And so we gather in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. And my brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came on earth to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you come to us in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd who leads us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And we pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son raised from the dead is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Hedy also find new strength. And we ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. And now you may be seated, and Donna will read for us our readings from Scripture, which are for us our consolation in knowing what Christ has prepared for us.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from his eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Donna will read for us our second reading from St. Paul to the Thessalonians.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus rose and died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this, on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with the word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Blessed are those who die in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds go with them. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When Jesus arrived in Bethany, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away. And many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." And Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." And Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection of the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" And she said to him, "Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who came into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Alleluia.
Our readings and scripture are meant to be a comfort for us, knowing that Hedy has gone to a place that God has prepared for her from all eternity. And Hedy was quite happy with that. When I went to anoint her, she was quite happy to know that she was going home to God. And that is our wonderful consolation. She was one beautiful woman who came here to worship her God, herself and her daughter. And she was a Eucharistic minister here. And you know, the beauty that we had, that the funeral home had set up around her in the gathering space. It was absolutely beautiful with the colors and the flowers that Hedy loved. She could not be more happy, I think, if she were here to look at it herself. And what I like also is the cover of this booklet. It's colorful. It's filled with colorful flowers, some that have bloomed and some that are about to bloom. When we pray at the offertory of the Mass, we pray, "Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation." I love this prayer. "Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for you have given us the bread and the wine we offer to you." And the bread and the wine are given us by God, but also we share in it. The bread is given to us from the earth, and humans mold that bread and those grapes into the gift that we offer to God. And you know what is our greatest consolation, and particularly at this Easter time? Our life has no meaning if it were not for the life of Christ, because he showed us what we are. We came into the world as he did, our God, who came as a child, a little baby. And he grew up as we grow up. He showed us how to do that. And then in suffering and death, he showed us the love of God for each of us. And then he rose from the dead. Our gospel here is telling us that. Jesus had heard that Lazarus, his great friend, and Martha and Mary, that he had died. And he waited for 2 days until he came, and Martha went out to meet him and said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Mary refused to come out to see him. Mary was the one who sat at his feet when he came to the house, and he was teaching with some of the disciples that were around him. And Mary, a woman, sat at his feet. It was unheard of, because he taught them the meaning of life. But now that he is coming to Lazarus, and she is totally, she can't take it that he hadn't come, and so she wouldn't even come out to meet him. But Martha and the rest went, and Jesus called Lazarus forth from the grave. That for us is the most wonderful thing. We even find in these days of Easter that Jesus passed that on to his apostles. Peter came in the early days of the church. He cured cripples. He raised the woman Tabitha from the dead. All to show us that our life is just a preparation for the place that God has prepared for us. And Hedy certainly was so much aware of that as she came to offer sacrifice to her Creator, to worship him here in this church. And I love the fact that she has asked that we do not come in mourning clothes, that we come with bright colors to show that we understand that she is with that loving God who has given us all creation. And so we'll stand, and we'll offer our prayers together. And Donna will again lead us in prayer. So, brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Hedy received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Hedy was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the family and friends of Hedy, in the long days ahead, find comfort and support in the love of their friends and community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That one day all of us will enjoy glorious new life in the company of Hedy and all the saints in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Our song during the offertory, the prayer of Saint Francis.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury or pardon, Lord. Where there's doubt, true faith in you.
Blessed are you.
Make
Lord
me
God
a channel
of, all creation,
of your peace.
For through your goodness we have received the bread life, we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, darkness, it will become for us the bread of life.
And where there's sadness, ever joy. Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual gift. Lord God, we offer you our sacrifice that it may be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Thank you. And pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on the offerings we bring, O Lord, so that your departed servant Hedy may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up, Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
And we offer this, our Mass, for Hedy and also for her husband David, who has joined her in heaven today. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels, the archangels, the thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
If you please, kneel. And you are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who loves the human race and who always walks with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when as once for his disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For on the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of our faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
And therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate this memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, all the bishops, priests, deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into your world. Remember our brothers and sisters, especially Hedy, who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we too may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. For it is through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. So we stand and we pray to God our Father, as Jesus, his Son, taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you now and always. And we share with each other Christ's peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, with faith in your love and mercy, we eat your body and drink your blood. Let it not bring us condemnation, but health in mind and body. And behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe to eternal life. And may the blood of Christ keep me safe to eternal life. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Now those who wish to come to communion may do so now. And if there are any who may not wish to come to communion but would like to receive a blessing, if you'd come with your arms folded on your chest and I will give you a blessing.
Our song during communion, I Danced in the Morning. The body of Christ.
I danced in the morning when the world was begun, and I danced in the moon and the stars and the sun. And I came down from heaven, and I danced on the earth. At Bethlehem I had my birth. Dance then, wherever you may be. I am the Lord.
word of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he.
May His Spirit be always with you to guide and protect you. May He give you His love and His peace.
I danced for the scribe and the Pharisee, but they wouldn't dance and they wouldn't follow me. I danced for the fishermen, for James and John. They came with me, and the dance went on. Dance then, wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. They took me down and I leap up high. I am the life that'll never, never die. I live in you if you'll live in me. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. Dance then, wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. And now I'd like to invite her daughter, Reyna, to come and share some memories with her of her wonderful mother. Thanks, Reyna.
Good morning. Thank you all for coming today to celebrate my mom. I know it would mean the world to her, and it does to me. Although she would hate all the attention. When my dad died, I was asked if I wanted to speak, and I was too emotional to do it, and I regretted it. One of the many things my mother taught me was that I'm stronger than I think I am. So I'm going to talk about her today, but forgive me if I cry. My mom taught me many things over the years. She taught me to be thoughtful to those that matter to me, whether it was to send a thank you note for a gift or find a present with significance for the person for a special occasion, but most importantly, to be present to them in their need and in their everyday life. She tried to do that for her friends. She tried to find or make sentimental gifts for special occasions. My friends may remember my 30th birthday, where my mom wrapped all of my gifts in page 30s of newspapers. She searched for the thoughtful gifts for her friends and made them, oftentimes finding, searching high and low. So many people have reached out to me to tell me a story about how thoughtful she was with little acts of kindness. She was a very generous person. She often joked she had inherited a few daughters along the way through my friendships. And they looked at her as another mother. Many years she received more than just my Mother's Day, Christmas, or birthday cards. She enjoyed spending time with them and talking with them, sharing their sorrows and their joys, celebrating their accomplishments. She loved them all dearly. And the feeling was mutual. To her friends, she was always available to listen, to give them a ride, or help them find their favorite author's books at the library when they weren't feeling well. Anyone who knows my mom knows a few things about her. She loved to read, and she loved to shop. She loved to do the Sunday New York Times crossword puzzle, and she loved bakeries. The joke between my parents was that when I was born, she said to my dad she was going to teach me to be a good bummer. That's what my grandparents and parents and godmother called shopping, bumming. And did we ever go bumming? Most weekends as an adult found me and mom going to one mall or three. She taught me to look for sales and to use coupons, and sometimes just to shop and browse. But it was those trips that I have so many memories of quality time with my mom, laughing over some ugly outfit we saw. And often on those trips, we would scout out bakeries she had found about and read about in the newspaper. She did get 4 Sunday newspapers for years. That's how she found out all those sales. As for the crossword puzzles, she got the Sunday Times on Saturday and would tear apart the paper to get the crossword first, and would painstakingly work on it, often getting it done by Sunday morning. Many of you may not know that my mom loved to watch sports. She loved golf, Father Sean, Arnold Palmer and Rory McIlroy being her favorites, tennis, Serena Williams and Novak Djokovic, who she patiently rooted for, and of course her beloved Pittsburgh Steelers and Green Bay Packers. I often teasingly, and my friends have heard this, called my mother, Mother Nature, as she would feed anything that showed up at the house, no matter how many legs it had, 2, 3, 4, 8, as a spider could be, feeding more than just humans, cats, deer, raccoons, skunks, even roosters, whom she named. My mom loved Christmas. She collected snowmen and angels, and each year we did our Christmas cookie marathon. I would take time off from work, and we would make 15 or so different kinds of cookies. We ended up giving the majority of them away, but we would start hunting for recipes around October, and then the week before Christmas, it was showtime. Exhausting, but so much fun. Each year for Christmas, we also did something different with our tree. Yet 1 year was all handmade ornaments, the opposite year it was a theme. Sometimes color, or all angels, or all snowmen. Once we decided on a theme, the scavenger hunt to find the decorations was on. One of my mom's great joys was being a volunteer librarian. At Brentford Library. She volunteered faithfully every week for nearly 40 years until last year when COVID shut it down. She loved finding books for people to read and helping people discover a new author. Once she knew that someone had found a new author they enjoyed, every once in a while she would research if they had written other books. If they had, she would sometimes surprise the patron and request a couple more books so that they could really enjoy that author. She got great enjoyment from watching the children in the summer reading program grow in their love of reading. Last summer, when we drove past the closed library, she said, "I feel sad for all those books that no one can read." She also taught me to love music. She accompanied me to every piano lesson, never missed a recital, concert, or band competition. She genuinely enjoyed music, even going with me to see Billy Joel twice. This love of music also drew us to enjoy Broadway. Over the years, we were able to see quite a few musicals. What many people don't know is I was the one that liked the old-fashioned ones like Oklahoma, and she wanted to see the newer ones like Hamilton. We always made a day out of it, going to St. Francis Church in Manhattan, then of course shopping, out to lunch, and then a show, the post-girls' day in the city. Her faith was extremely important to her. She had a strong devotion to the Infant of Prague. Her devotion to the Infant of Prague is so strong in my memory, she would pray to the infant before each and every trip we ever took. She was proud of being a Eucharistic minister here at Mary Mother of God, and she missed it once COVID hit and she wasn't able to attend Mass. She also had a strong devotion to our Blessed Mother, and her rosary became even more comforting to her as she continued to pray it nearly every day until her last. I was actually praying it for her when she died. Most importantly, my mom taught me to love fiercely and honestly, sometimes quietly, but always with strength. She was truly the strongest person I've ever known as she faced her illness with a quiet dignity. She never complained, never asked why me, and was the best patient. I'm forever grateful I got to spend all my time with her these last few months. I will miss her every day, but I am comforted to know she is reunited with my dad, her parents, her favorite aunts and uncles, her cousins, and her friends that have gone before her, and she is finally with our Lord. After we lost my dad, we stopped saying goodbye to each other. It was always so long or see you later, but always I love you. I love you, Mommy, so long. See you later.
Thank you, Reyna, for sharing those memories of your mom. And thank you for having the courage to do it. It is so important that we can share the memories of our loved ones, because that's what Jesus on the road to Emmaus encouraged his disciples to think of the times they had with him and the love they shared with him. And now we'll pray that wonderful prayer to Mary, our mother. For her intercession, we pray the Ave Maria.
Amen.
And I'd like, before our final prayer, to pray the shield of St. Patrick, his prayer, Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within your wounds, hide me. Separated from you, let me never be. From the malignant enemy, defend me. At the hour of death, call me. To come to you, bid me, that I may praise you in the company of your saints for all eternity. Amen. And so we pray. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even though he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Hedy, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrifice, may pass over to your dwelling place of light and peace. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God.
And finally, we pray. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Hedy. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life. The Lord is my light and my help. It is he who protects me from harm. The Lord is the strength of my days. Before whom should I tremble with fear? May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life.
And as we offer her mortal remains with incense, we pray that our prayers, like incense, may rise for her before the throne of God. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Hedy. In the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks, Lord, for the blessings you bestowed upon Hedy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of our faith, until we all meet again in Christ, and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
I, the Lord of sea and the sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
May the angels come to meet you. The martyrs welcome you to the place in heaven which God has prepared for you from all eternity. May you enjoy his love and his peace now and forever. Amen.
Church truck, please. Gentlemen, lift on three. One, two, and three. Step right here. Okay. Just take the church truck out of the way, off to the side. We'll put it away in a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, we're just going to ask you to gather around here for a moment, if you will. We'll just give a chance for everybody to join with us. Just gather around, folks, obviously. Social distancing and all that good stuff. Well, after hearing that, I think we know Reyna certainly got a lot from her dad, but boy, did she get a lot from her mom in a good way. And I know she's also mad at me for telling her how proud we are for her for getting up and doing that, but you honored your mother, Reyna. and you do every day. Again, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Reyna and her family, a very sincere thank you to all of you for your love and support, and all of you who are watching virtually. Please know that, again, as I said before Mass, your calls, your texts, your just reaching out randomly to check in means a lot, and I know that'll continue with, I know a lot of this group, I know I don't need to encourage that, because that'll continue long after this day is over. As a reminder, from here we're going directly to the crematory at Somerset Hills Memorial Park. We're going to be, I'm going to check the traffic reports, we're going to go two ways. We're probably not going to go 206, it's a little jammed up. We're probably going to sneak through Raritan up First Avenue and out to 287. Just as a reminder, the state police encourage us not to go slow, so we have to keep a pretty brisk pace. Usually we try to stay in the middle lane. Again, the directions you received prior to Mass have the address on there. Once we get there, if you get there ahead of us, you're certainly welcome to go ahead. Just as you go in the main gate at Somerset Hills, it's a big, big driveway. Just pull off to the side and wait till we get there, and then you can follow us there, and then you'll follow the instructions of the cemetery personnel upon our arrival. Again, don't rush. We have some people who need a little assistance. We're going to make sure that everybody is together before we start our committal prayers. If for some reason you don't feel comfortable going to the crematory, as I said, it's a big, beautiful chapel. There's not anything you're going to see that would be offensive, but everybody has their comfort level, and Reyna didn't want to make anybody feel excluded. You're welcome to go directly to Stony Brook Grill and North Branch on Route 28. They have the room ready for you. You're certainly welcome to have a cocktail or water and wait for the, or anything else, right? Or wait for the family to arrive. If you are going with us in a few moments, this red van behind me is going to pull out behind the hearse. After that, most of you who've said you were going are already in line. High beam headlights and four-way flasher lights. Please remember, with your four-way flasher lights, people behind you can't tell if you're getting to the left or the right. So again, your safety is of our utmost concern today. I do again realize that many people have to go back to work, and I know some of you are going to be leaving the live stream shortly, but if you couldn't make it to church but can make it for lunch, that's okay also. We don't check badges here. It's okay. Time together is what really matters. But we wanted to give those of you who are not going to the crematory a chance to come forward to kiss or touch or whatever you need to do at the casket for your final prayer before you take your leave and head back to your vehicles. Everybody who's going with us to the crematory, you can proceed directly to your vehicles at this time. Reyna, I'm going to ask you just to stand here so you can greet some of those folks who won't be able to join us later. You can come right this way, ladies and gentlemen, if you are not accompanying us and would like to take your final see you later, as Reyna said, and give the final I love you. That's certainly welcome.
Thank you.